chambers is in Isaiah chapter 54. Because today I want us to talk on a different dimension. Hallelujah. Glory to God. It was Isaiah chapter 54. The Bible says, "See, O barren, that didst not bear, break forth into singing and cry aloud, that thou did not travail with child. For more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married wife, says the Lord. Enlarge the place of your tent, and let them stretch forth the curtains of your habitation. Spare not." God says, do not spare. When it comes to enlargement, do not limit him. When it comes to your vision and dreams, do not limit him. Spare not. The Bible says, lengthen the cords of the cords and strengthen thy sticks. For thou shalt break forth on the right hand and on the left. Thy seed shall inherit the Gentiles and make the desolate cities to be inhabited. One of the principal cornerstones of enlargement. When you get to a point that you're saying, my life has been stagnated, I've marked time for too long, the Bible says, break into singing. Break into singing. Praise the name of Jesus. Church of God, one thing we need to realize, that praise is a key holder to your enlargement. When you are told to praise, don't look like, what are they saying? I don't like that song. It is not for you. It is to the Holy Ghost. We've got to deal with the elements of pride, because that has kept many people from praise. You feel like, my class, my standard, you have been told Terenka. Oh my God. Yo, Simba. Abuka, tell me Terenka. No way. You sing yourself. Sing yourself. Ela sana Terenka, but she does like a huyo sana Terenka. Tuko pamoja. Anapoinuka na Yesu, anapoinua Bwana Yesu asifiwe. It takes the heart of a child to touch the heart of God. It takes the simplicity of the gospel to change your place to the dimension that God desires of you. It takes the simplicity just to obey. The Bible says, see, O barren, you look at your life and nothing is happening. But God is saying, see, you look at your situation and nothing has changed. But God is telling you, see. You look at the prayer points that you are praying, and none of them seems to be answered. But God is telling you, see. You go into your wardrobe, and the same clothes you wore 2 years ago are the same ones you're wearing. And God tells you, see. Do not murmur. Do not complain. He tells you, do you need an enlargement? The principles of Jehovah are different from the principles of man. The principles of man, when they're in a time or a place of a strange place, they complain, they cry, and they murmur. But the principles of Jehovah are different. He tells you, is nothing happening in your life? Sing, O ye barren. That means there is no seed that you have been able to conceive. You have not been able to bring forth. But God says it's not about complaining. It does not matter the situation. God is captivity. Don't murmur and don't complain when the children of Israel murmured in the wilderness. The Bible tells me that God releases serpents. Murmuring releases demonic forces to destroy. And God watches. But this woman is being told in the book of Isaiah. This man is being told in the book of Isaiah. It may not have gone your way. It may not have gone your way. But do one thing. Praise. Why? Because praise is a changer of destiny. Praise will change the gear in my life. I may have been moving on neutral, but the minute I begin to praise, I engage gear number one and I begin to move. Hallelujah. The Bible says, bring forth sin, O barren that did not bear. Bring forth into singing and cry aloud. When you are told to shout unto the Lord, don't try to tell me that is not like me. Shout. I have an issue with noise, you know? But in those matters, I do bad, ooh, bad. But in church, when you are told to shout to the Lord, you know how to be seen your teeth. Even if you need brush, you're not brush shouting to me. You're shouting to the Lord. Hallelujah. It is a command, and I will do the commanded work, and I will get the commanded blessing. And I have said this countless times. When I was told I had cancerous tumors in my womb, I remember I was standing and there was so much pain in my body. And the doctors had said it has to be an urgent operation or else. And you know when they say or else, you know what they're saying. And with my husband, we said there's going to be no or else. I say there's a scripture in Kikuyu that says, Me, I just stood on that because I don't even know it in English. I can only translate, I don't know if it fits. That the blood of Modoaka. The blood of the righteous. Who has been taking her to school? The blood of the righteous shall not pour out like the blood of an animal. I only know it. It shall not. And I said, I'm not going under any knife at it to remove my wound. No. And I remember it had grown so big, I was wearing three dresses. And of course, even Pastor Kathy, then my pastor, because I was in JCC, was telling me we were waiting for this baby and also saying yes. Little did I know I was carrying. And as I stood in a church, we were told shout to the Lord. We were sitting front row, and then there like a person, and imagining everybody is looking at you. But when you were told to shout, I shouted, like there was no tomorrow. And immediately the pain left. Cancer died immediately on the shout of the Lord. I have gone to the hospital, I think, 3 times, 4 times. And my body is clean of any growth. Completely clean. I went and I told them I need a certificate of clearance. Do a scan. And they did a scan. I was asked, why are you coming? I told them this was the previous report. It is still at home. Both are still at home. Why? It was at the shout of the Almighty. Because God inhabits the place of his praises. And it does not only inhabit a corporate anointing, because when you praise, there's a corporate anointing, but now he is looking for an individual worshiper, an individual praiser, who will come into the church and say, I have come to offer you the very song that you love. It is praise. And God enlarged my life. I could have been so long dead. And I told God, you know what? Death will never praise you. And I used to ask God, if I die, who will praise you like I do? Show me. I know you're there. I'm talking of my own. I used to tell him, show me. The minute you show me, let's get talking. Because praise is a key to the next dimension. I'm not surprised that Abuka keeps giving testimonies. But it's a praise. Are we together? I am not surprised that all of you now will start giving testimonies, including you at the back. Why? Because you've got to learn the art, the power of praise. The lady who gave her testimony. testimony here. She said a song rose up of praise in her heart. And as she was singing the song, they got the sound back. What of yours is missing? Is it your creativity? That you no longer have enough creativity on your own career? Do you know creativity is like idea? When I said, I used to have a lot of divine ideas. Right now, to give you a 50,000, which I can give you, so you have to give me, because I want to invest in it. Say amen. That creativity is coming back. Say amen.
Amen.
Divine supernatural ideas. Say amen.
Amen.
That whatever stone your brain is restoring it today as we praise. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Some of you say, I don't know what stole my joy. I don't know what stole the joy of my salvation. But you're being told, I want to enlarge you. Praise. Some of you say, I don't even have that kind of a voice. You're like Esther of Patrick. Have you ever heard her key? Nobody knows which key she sings. Nobody has a clue. But she says she sings. So you see, she sings. Where heaven knows. To go back on. But she sings because indeed she's enlarged. Are we together? Mr. Ruto, now you can even start your own choir in the house. Praise the Lord. Have you reached at a point of death end? Have you reached a point where you're saying, I've been under this ceiling for too long? When I rise above the ceiling, I am hit and I come down. I rise with 5,000, I fall with 10,000. God is telling you, sing. Make a shout of joy. Make a shout of joy. Praise the name of Jesus. You wonder why children, God protects them supernaturally, because they sing just like children. You find them singing melody in heart, and you say, I'm a daughter or two. That's why they're protected. And you who is very mature, you've got to keep, no, I won't fash out again in front of, no, I won't. It is true to take the word, but these children got their protection when they hid under the shadow of the Almighty. Praise the name of Jesus. And the Bible says, break forth and shout aloud, thou that did not travail. And then God says, many shall be the children of the barren. Many. Many. When you begin to shout to the Lord, when you begin to praise the Lord, when a song is there and you are trying to sing it even if you don't know it. If you can't think, tell God I'm praising you with my hand clap. Get a kayamba. Tell God I'm praising you with my kayamba. Get a dance. Tell God I'm praising you in the dance. The Bible says then you begin to break forth. God begins to connect you with your destiny help. God begins to take you to your next level. Hallelujah. I want us to go to Psalms chapter 67. Psalms chapter 67. Hallelujah. I want us to study this. And as much as I prepared so much for today, I just want us to just zero in on your praise. 67. God be merciful unto us and bless us, and cause his face to shine upon us. This was a man praying, oh God, be merciful. Sumulikie Baba. And you have a zile nyimbo tunaimba, nimulikie Bwana nimulikie. You know some of you are not yet born again, so you are not yet born again, but you are not born. So those are the songs of those days. All of us, we go to Karuna Forest and we hear somebody has started, because all of us are without the word of God, so we only used to travel in prayer. Nasikia moja ameanza naona maajabu Bwana ukimulika. So we all cry as we are singing. And I said, God does not respond to tears. Are we together? I said, nimulikie Baba. Imagine the darkness in Milele. And you are thinking I'm almost through the Karuna Forest. Oh, but don't cry today. No. Instead of crying, we should have done something different. The Bible says, that thy ways may be known unto the upon the earth, thy saving health upon the nations. Verse 3. This man gets a revelation. And his revelation, he realizes, going to pray about it. And verse 3, let the people praise thee, O God. Let all the people praise thee. Let the people praise thee, O God. Let all the people praise thee. He got a new revelation that this dimension you are looking for, it is coming at the altar of praise. When we raise an altar of praise, then God begins to visit. And the Bible says, oh, let the nations be glad and sing for joy. This man stopped telling God, oh, to Muliki as a nation. He told not God something different. Let the nations begin to get joy. Joy to worship, joy to praise, joy to shout aloud. Let the nations, Jehovah, let the shelter, let my family, let my home, let my life, what I look at, Namuinuko, what Sifa. Hallelujah. The Bible says, let the people praise you, O God, let all the people praise you. He continues, verse 4, was this summary? No, he was laying an emphasis. He says, oh, let the nations be glad and sing for joy. For thou shalt judge the people righteously and govern the nations upon the earth. He repeats the third time. This should be your prayer. Papa, nifungulie nikuabudu. Nifungue kinywa changu nikuabudu. Fungua moyo wangu nikuabudu. My God, fungua mawazo yangu ya kuabudu. And all that is within me, bless your holy name. If you see how bad sin for the Lord, David sin with their two brothers. I was watching a video where the horses were dancing and they are singing to the Lord with their feet. When we are told just to move our feet, you are thinking me, and God gave you shoes. When we are sitting your shoes, man, you can give you 10 pairs, amen. Glory to God. The Bible says, let the nations praise him. Let all the people praise him. Up to verse 5. He's still making a petition to God. The Bible gives a reason. Verse 6. Then shall the earth yield her increase. After you have obeyed. It's not before. You don't get enlargement before. And that's why the book of Isaiah chapter 3 verse 10, the Bible says, if they be willing and obedient, then they shall eat the good of the land. You're willing to praise, but now you have to obey and praise. Hallelujah. Don't just be desiring to praise, but actually praise. The Bible says, then shall the earth yield her increase. What is it that you are doing? What is your earth? Your earth is your income source. Is your shop netting 2,000? All I need to do after I've obeyed the principles of God is now to praise. Is your life holding at the same level? Oh, God is telling us, let the people praise thee. Then the earth shall yield her increase. This is covenant. The covenant between God and man and the earth. This is a covenant between friends, a triune covenant. A covenant between God. God, I'll give you my praise. And God says, when you give me my praise, then I will cause the earth to bring forth enlargement. Do you understand that? My praise will rise to God. When God receives my praise, then my earth will begin to yield its increase. Until God has received your praise, you do not have a covenant right to demand for increase. Let me repeat that. Until God has received your praise, you do not have a covenant right to demand for increase. Because God will say, yes, it is not on my side to increase you. It is not on my side to increase you. It is on your side to increase yourself. How will you increase yourself? I will wake up in the morning and I will sing. I will walk by the road and I will sing. Long time ago, we used to sit in matatus. You know those matatus that were face me, I face you. You get them? Yeah, you face me, I face you. Nakana, tunaenda hivi, nukata tunaenda hivi, you're just facing this one, mpaka mnaanza kusalimiana. You're still a team or half or too long, niyase. And you almost are exchanging your boxes all around the batatu because of the fellowship of Face Me and Face You. But in those days, there's something that used to happen. You could hear a woman begin a song or a man. Is it true? And the long distance matatus. Nego go go shakai, todo mada shaku. And everybody joins in. Nada kame ajenso mokori. That's the village where I come from. Me, I don't know if you were speaking in your village. I told you I'm a villager. And by the time we are getting to our destination, everybody is singing. Even the drunkards would sing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. But he's still praising. Do you get what I'm saying? And look at the rate of crime those days. It was lower than now. Their children were mighty in the land. We are the seeds of those generations. Why? There are people who used to praise. I want to dare you today. If today the blessing and the enlargement of your land can be equivalent to your blood, to your praise, what extent could you receive from the Lord? What extent could you receive of the Lord, Chris? I am very sure Chris sees in his dreams. But I see him singing. But I don't know his voice. We don't even need to know your tone. Tuko pamoja. Ni wewe na Mungu wako. Hallelujah. Nani, wewe na nani, na Mungu wako. When we come to this place, like I remember when the choir don't read song and sang, and the presence of God was as present as a fire. Now that time the yokes are broken, sicknesses are healed. That is corporate anointing. Yokes are broken, sicknesses are healed. Because there's the manifest presence of God. Church of God, we've got to discipline ourselves to stop murmuring and to begin to sing. The Bible says, the earth shall yield her increase, and God, listen, now this is very funny, and God, even our God shall bless us. He says God, and he wants to qualify which one. He says that God, even our God shall bless us. God shall bless us, and all the ends of the earth shall fear him. That's what the Bible says. God shall bless us. What will happen? The ends of the earth will be looking at what God has done in your life, and they will fear your God. And that's why it says, even our God. This is the God of the testimony. Church of God, you have been looking at an area in your life that seems like it died. But today, at the altar of praise, at the altar of worship, you can resurrect your life again. You need to go to your house and say, this time I dedicate it for worship. Those songs that you are putting in your phones, there are some people here, if you tell them, please let me have your phone. Zile liko zinaibwa ni mdu liko. Anasema hizi ni za mataro. Ni mawaida hapa na hapa na mawaida mapoa. You know me, I don't even listen to Zekia, but hii ni mawaida. Which mawaida go beyond this one? This is the ultimate mawaida. Are we together? You've got to put praise in your house. If you sense the spirit of heaviness, weka worship. Lala tuwe lala wate ikicheza. Wacha tu worship ikicheza. Where the land? Every mom yet has defeated you, Kuta. The fear in me was too much because you know I'm not hooked up with God. My confidence was a chum as a 1946. Friend, I don't know how to see that and I mean, Papa Lomi, see where I live. What he called his mother had grill, you take a spoon and daddy. It pushed the curtain open. And the number of multitude against us was so big. And I remember as we were praying, and you know, we were prayers as in me. Yeah, that's cool, man. I'm all big. You know, but you know, I'm here. 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 You know, I'm Hey! Unless you speak a new word. My God, it is midnight. And if you don't reach your place, one house is here, the other house is far away because we're in a half acre. And after our house was a park, just towards the house that was going to the river, and then the other side is a forest. So it's either the coffee plantation on one side, or the park, and of course there's nobody that's used to access it, or the forest, and they have come from the forest. Now, hakika ni kama wakiingia. Wakwanza kwanza akapanda, akaingia hiko. Nikamwona kwa nyumba, nikasonga. Wakaingia one after another, after another, after another. It was not time for prayer. My friend, it was not time for prayer. And we began to praise. The grace of praise came down. And we began to praise the God that answered by fire. Sindio tulikuwa naimba. And we said, let the God that answered by fire, let him be my God. The God that answered by fire. We sang so loudly, even louder than they were talking. Let him be my God. Let him be my God. Let him be my God. Rompers on the jump for you. No, it happened. In the bedroom, it happened. They are squeezing to get space. You get what I'm saying? And as you're going, let him be my God, let him be my God. Then God that answered by fire, let him be. And you sang. My friend, a man akakuja na shoka. Now, you know, the axe, the blade is very long, the kahando is short. And now he aimed it at the pastor's head. Akasema, well, you come, akata kufungua. Now he aimed it straight at his head. And he looked at him and he said, no weapon fashioned against me can prosper. He can be a good friend, let me just move. And don't forget me in the house. And so I wanted him to interpret that scripture so that he can understand why he's not going to cut you. And I was thinking, how do we say it in Kikuyu? Because now, it is like, you know, they are doing that in rituals. They would come and of course kill the head and rape the woman. It was like a revenge. And I told him, and he said, and you know they're in the house. He told me, it doesn't matter, but God and the devil understand what I've said. And he told the man again, I told him, no weapon fashioned against me or anybody in this house will prosper. Oh, the fire of worship, that's a catch. Let it be my God, let it be my God. Let it. You know you are singing life and death. Do you get what I'm saying? Your praise is your life or your death. And they're already in the house. One of these collects, Tima, Tima, Tima. Kila kitu iko giza. I want to tell you there is power in praise. Some of the situations you have been crying, you need to praise. And the man who had carried the axe, akaiweka hapa kama hapa. Akaanza kuzurura na kwa nyumba sasa anaibeba kama hapa. Wakazurura na utuuliza, kwa nini huko? Tumebezi kwa nabi ya pana msibebe kwa, oh, tuwetende nazo. Aya. Sisi tunataka TV. TV. Sisi tunataka TV. And I'm telling you, those people are so many. But it got to a point, church. Well, now we are told you have to open for the head. Because it can't fit there. You know, in my life since I was born to today, I've never seen that kind of a man. We had to go and open for him the door. And as I was opening the door, he was offering praises. I was opening the door with praise because I don't know what the Amiga means. Because he said, wakati ya kadino imefika. End of Google Blanco idea kwa dirisha. When we opened, he could not fit on a door. He had to bend. Alikuwa amevaa kinyasa inatosha na hivi tu. Amejipaka mafuta mwili and he was so big. Alikuwa amebeba chuma mie so Goliath. I will never forget. And Cardinal came with his harassment, mapaka na masoka na kila kitu. And we began to sing. We continue to praise. They began to cut each other in our eyes. When the other sio kweli. Wakaanza kukatana hivi na machoko. Unaona wewe amekatwa mguu, nyama imeanguka hivi. Now I'm thinking, God, sasa wakimalizana, is it going to be us? You get so nilikuwa na jina sasa tuzimeo, praise kidogo. They began to slay each other in our house. God does not change. Wakakatana, wakakata. Then they started using the blunt side of the axe. Where, for no reason, who began and who? The battle was so violent. I knew God, if they are doing this against themselves, who are you talking about us? Unless you're on our side. And we continue, we never stop singing. A point came at which they say, they have left the room for cardinals. Nikakuja nikachukuliwa by two of them. And I stood, because of some distance between the bedroom to the sitting room, I told Jehovah, this is your altar. The altar and the temple of the Holy Ghost. Indeed, if your God be the keeper of this temple, no man shall defend it. And I remember I told them, no man will defend this temple. And I left him singing. And when we were just about to get to the sitting room, because cushions were put on the way back, there were about 7 men. To kaskia mlipuko, uliita mpaka police kutoka kuzaika police station. What was happening? Jehovah began to fight. Mlipuko, me, I was myself. I mean, they're so bad. They didn't come with guns. But the funny thing was, when you went to hide under the bed because you were afraid of the bullets, the same robbers were hiding under the bed and so people to kill. Shh. And others were Naruka. So I asked them, Mkona, Pasha, cook it. And you mean, wait, some have put like a blanket to defeat a vizuri. This is what we were under the bed. And I'm looking at this man. And I thought, oh, it was the hand of Jehovah. They scattered one after the other. This is what God can do. And we have never been able to explain how that mabati, because one of the gentlemen who had given a servant quota, he just hit a mabati and walked out. We've never been able to explain to today how just a small of a mabati, walking out of a mabati, he became so vibrant that police came from Udaika. And they said, we thought there's a bazooka. They knew the kind of war happening in that place is not normal. It was God who vibrated it. They disappeared. What am I telling you? I don't know what has accosted your life, but there is a God who manifests in praises. There is a God who comes through with his own strength. I know your strength, pengine imefika mwisho. Maombi yako imefika mwisho. Kungojea Jehovah kumefika mwisho. Hata kumtumainia Mungu hakika kumefika mwisho. Ukijiangalia wana umezingirwa na adui. But today I'm telling you to raise a praise. Today I'm daring you to raise a worship. As you worship, God deals with your enemies on one side, on the other side, he causes your